We're gonna play a tattletale quickie now. And here it comes, fellas. I'm gonna ask you the question. Don't give me the answer yet. Here it is. Men, do you ever wish you had played around more when you were single? I'll repeat that. Men, do you ever wish you had played around more when you were single? Think about that, fellas. And we'll get back to you in a minute. Oh, ladies, if you could see those faces. Barbara, how do you think Dick will respond to that question?
Well, if he'd played around anymore, there wouldn't have been anything left for me.
So the answer, the questions that come to mind. Barbara, what do you want to give then as a response to that?
What? I've forgotten the question.
You want to know what? So am I. I can't remember it either. Let me see what it says. Do you ever wish you had played around more when you were single is the question. And that's to the men.
Well, you know, he really wasn't single very long because he was married before me. Mm-hmm. So let me see. Does he wish that he had played around more? Well, no, I'm going to say no, I think. No.
Okay.
You're
going to say no. All right.
I think.
But you're going to go with that.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, let's bring on the fellas. Let's bring on Dick. All right,
Bert,
Dick.
Bert, first of all, let me say something. There are only so many hours in a day. I mean, you know, a human being can only take so much burden.
Yes, I know.
All right.
Now, you've been... Okay. let's get back online here, Dick.
All right.
Did you ever wish, in fact, that you had played around more when you were single?
I'm doing it now. No. Yes.
Yes, huh? Well, obviously, Barbara did not agree with that.
Did not agree with you. Think that that was it for me? One girl and then you?
That's not the way I heard it.
Well, sometimes under pressure, we get the real story here, you know, on Tattletales.
Honey, for goodness sakes, you were married when you were 14 or something. I don't know. When would you have had time to be single?
That's why I regret it.
Now, don't fight, kids. Sorry, no score there. Thank you, Dick. All right, Patty, how about Donald? Is he going to wish he had played around more when he was single?
Yeah, Donald was busy, but he's greedy.
So you're going to say yes, right?
Yes.
Okay, let's bring on busy but greedy. All right, Donald, what is your answer to that, sir?
You better believe it.
That's what you said. You're right, Donald, for $100.
Now I have a curfew.
What was that, Donald?
Now I have a curfew.
Now you have a curfew?
I have a curfew and I have a leash. I have very little freedom.
Oh, boy. Well, you won that $100 for your rooting section, so it can't be all bad. Thanks, Donald. Okay, Jane, how about James?
Yeah, I think he definitely wished he'd played around more. Yeah, because he didn't play around that much. And then we were married, you know, 12 days after we met. So it was a little late. So now he'd like to do it now, and I'm following him around. So he can't do it.
It's too late now.
It's too late.
Okay, you say yes, he would wish he had. All right, let's bring on James. James.
Huh?
What is the answer to that question, sir? Do you, in fact, wish you had played around more when you were single?
Yeah, I wish I could, yes.
That's what James said. You're right, $100. That is halftime. Our score at this point is Barbara and Dick have $100. Jane and James have $100. Patty and Donald are in the lead with $200. Ladies, if you will, step to the rear. Gentlemen, come on out in front. And while we're changing places, we're going to break away for a little message, but we're coming back in just a minute. Don't go away. Half more to go. Okay, we're back. We've changed places. You know our studio audience is sharing in the winnings, and everybody in our audience today, by the way, is guaranteed to go home with some money. We've all got a score up here, so that's nice to be able to say, but it's also nice to be able to say that if your rooting section is backing our top winning celebrity couple today, we will add a bonus of $1,000. All right. I have the gentleman out here with me. Let's see if your ladies are all right backstage. All right, you got the earphones on, ladies? Ready to go?
Oh, yes.
Ready.
All right.
Your hair looks terrific. Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
It looks just fine. I'm not you, fellas. Oh. All three guys said thank you. All right, ladies, we'll get back to you in just a moment. Listen to the music. Gentlemen, It is now your turn. I'm going to ask you questions now about you, your lives, with your wives. When you have an answer you think she'll recognize, press that button. Be fast and be first. I'll only take one. Here we go. First question. A story about a relative.
You first, Dick. It was close, but you were first.
Barbara's mother is in her 70s. She's a lovely, white-haired little old lady from the Midwest. And she had never had the experience, evidently, of having seen an X-rated picture.
Ooh.
And she requested that we take her to see, I won't mention the name, but the biggest and biggest drawing X-rated movie of all time.
Right.
And I said to her, I said, Lillian, do you really know what this movie is about? And she said, oh, yes, I know what the movie is about. And I said, are you sure? And she said, yeah. And we took her and we paid our $5, you know, $15 for the three of us to go in. And Barbara said, you better watch this because it's $5 a piece. And she said, oh, don't worry about me. I want to see this. It'll be a new experience for me. And she walked in and she looked up at the screen. She went, Hazeba! And that was it. For an hour and a half, she stood there and she said, you know, she sat there and she said, tell me when it's over. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. And that she never looked at the screen again.
Never saw it.
It's true.
Okay, so what we need now is a one or two word clue for a story about a relative.
The only word, why don't we say porno? Because if we say movie, that will, let's say porno.
Porno.
I think so, yeah.
Okay, that's what we'll say.
I loved it, though, by the way.
All right, let's bring on the ladies. Ladies, we have asked the fellas a question and we have a clue. Sound that signal when you recognize your husband and you think you can match his story from this clue. Here is the question first. A story about a relative. And the clue is porno. Barbara. That deep intake of air means that you are up.
My poor mother will die when she sees the show. Honey, we'll have to leave the country. Oh, wait till her relatives see that back in Illinois. They'll never let up on her. I love it. No, but we took her to the theater, and we told her that, you know, she had wanted to see a pornographic movie. And we said, all right, we'll take you to one, but boy, you better keep your mouth shut and don't say one word. And so she said, all right, she promised. I mean, she's a sweet little lady in a different generation, right? So they don't know about those things. Okay.
That's what he said. You're right, for $100, dear.
Okay.
At this point, Jane and James have $100. Patty and Donald, Barbara and Dick are tied with $200 apiece. Good close game. We'll be back in a minute with more Tattletales after this message for you.
Can yell.
Big
luck. You can plead.
Come on.
You can scream.
I'm gonna get the big bucks.
But sooner or later, you're gonna realize there's no defense against a whammy. Press your luck today at 9:30 and 1:30 Eastern. Tonight at 9:30 and 1:30 Eastern.